I'm Chad Glen, we're at Georgia Tech, and I work with gap junctions, so it has a relation to a lot of diseases, actually. So cancer has some relation. There's also some association with Parkinson's and Alzheimer's. I'm actually from Canada, Hamilton, Ontario, so I'm far away from home. When I was younger, I played or did karate for a while, and I really enjoyed reading. But when I got into it, I really went into it. I was way too curious when I was younger, and when I started drinking coffee, I looked up the effects of caffeine, and then I was like, okay, caffeine is a phosphodiesterase inhibitor. And I was like, oh, what does that mean? And so I looked that up, and it just ended up with me reading a whole bunch of research articles at a great age of like 13. When I was younger, we had a class, and a guy came in to give a presentation on like career day, and he's like, I'm a scientist, and I get to pick my own hours. And my first response was, that's what I want. I actually was a weird child in that before the boogeyman, I was actually scared of cancer. My parents used to scare me to eat my vegetables by saying, you'll get cancer. And so obviously I ate my broccoli. And then I was like, you know, maybe I should actually work towards something that could prevent this or at least help this. And so it was really a fear of cancer that drove me here. My overall goal is actually trying to figure out how cells in like populations or aggregates are actually communicating. So there's like proteins called connexins that form like gap junctions, so basically channels between cells so they can allow things to pass directly through. And I'm trying to figure out how in a large population this communication network is actually arranged and how like spatial patterns could form from that, and really just trying to find out how, if there's rules that govern this intercellular communication in multiple different cell types, you'd pretty much have regular stuff in the lab, pipettes, flow cytometry, which allows you to separate different cells based on like fluorescent tags and get a size distribution. My dreams for where this can go is really by creating this model of intercellular communication. I hope that I can actually determine what is going wrong, especially in diseases like Parkinson's or Alzheimer's, and also epilepsy. There's like some disruption in gap junction function that I think my research could help to develop some connection between what is going wrong to cause the symptoms and how you can potentially correct it.
I am, yes.
Oh, wow.
The most special thing about the lab is definitely the ability to actually come in, talk to people, and then go do research, come back, still have a conversation.
Where's your protective gear?
Where's my protective gear? It's okay. It's just cancer cells, so it's not going to hurt. What hurts you makes you stronger, right?
I don't know if that quite works in science, but...
Very interesting work.
And everyone sort of understands exactly, like, they don't think, oh, he's sitting at his computer, he's not doing any work. It's, oh, he's in between experiments, because there's always these long, like, breaks in between, and it's a great place to be. The fact that you can actually understand exactly what's going on in your own life, for the most part. Just everything you could possibly want to know is collected together, and you slowly cascade between different points, and it's a great experience.